Hi everyone, and welcome to another daily video from Shopify Dropshipping Lifestyle. My name is Ricky Hayes. It's lovely to meet you all. Today's video is about how to minimize where's my order emails, okay? So let's get straight into it. All right, so how this works is it's actually very simple. There's a few ways of doing it. I use Klaviyo. There's other email service providers. You can do it with them, of course, but I use Klaviyo, and this is another reason why. So where you want to start, and don't do this until you've at least gotten, 5 to 10 orders a day. It's not worth it if you're getting a couple a day at that stage. I mean, it doesn't take long, but it's just something that's just on the back of your mind at that point, let's be honest. So how I do this is that on my stores now, I have gone through, except these because I haven't really cared, order notifications are irrelevant. But anyway, basically, if you go into settings, notifications, this is the default triggers that Shopify sends out for emails. There's a lot of businesses that I've helped that use the default ones. And it's fine, but they're wasting their time. Especially if you're a big business, this is important shit. So what I do is I get my email marketer and I've just made nice templates for every one of these. It's a one-off. You can change it at any stage. It's super easy. And it'll save you a lot of time and it'll help build your brand. Because if you have a look here, so if I go in the default order confirmation, I'll have all the jargon. And we go preview. There you go. See how that sort of looks? Meh. Doesn't have your logo. I mean, I don't have a logo, sorry. So, but basically, you can do a lot with this. You can do a lot with this, and you can really push your brand. And this is what's cool about Klaviyo. So, I change these so that it has the necessary information in it. And you can change it however you want. Basically, how you need to do it, is I'll just go into an overview. If you want the templates, or sort of a sort of overview of the template, on your FAQ page, you should have your shipping time frames. So you just copy it out of there. But I can give you sort of the one that I use if you're interested. Just drop a comment below if you are. But basically, this is the default one. And so you want to change the order confirmation and the shipping confirmation. So the reason that you want to change those two first is order confirmation is once they've ordered or purchased. And the other one is once the order has been fulfilled, they get their unique tracking number and they get an email. So they get an email. And so both these points, you can tell them, hey, this is the expected time frame. And a lot of people will read it, a lot of people won't, but it's an email that just has some simple text that says, hey, we expect the time frame to be something like this, okay? So, just one sec. I just got to log into my Klaviyo account. I just forgot to do that. Sorry about that. So, further to this, so we've got the templates. And the other cool thing is once you integrate Klaviyo, which is just a step-by-step guide, basically you put in your Shopify store name. So, in my case, dropshippinglifestyle.myshopify.com. It will pull all that info in. You just put in your personal details. Going through all that in another video. Basically then, you go into your email templates. This is why I really like Klaviyo. Is it pulls in the templates. So we just look for order confirmation, Shopify order confirmation. And again, you modify this based off your brand, your unique message. I'm just sort of giving you the template, sorry, I should say. So you can see how this straight away looks so much better than this. So if we just compare that, and then where's the preview? I've forgotten where the preview is. Anyway, but that is sort of the preview. You can see, obviously, it's got all that. You can take as much of this stuff out as you want. You know, you got your, I wouldn't take that out. You got your order line details. That'll just dynamically add. You got your shipping address, you got your billing address. The email is to confirm the blah, blah, your order. And then you can put some additional text. You can put, We are so thankful for your order or something. I don't know. But basically here, you want to put, I put this. Yeah, this. So I actually, and again, whoops, sorry. This is blah, blah, blah. I don't know. I have to check. Anyway. So what I will, just 1 sec, do is, you know, you put in first name variable. And, you know, the, for whatever reason, the spacing is crap. Bad. You can take out this. I like to be more, the more informative, the better in these emails. It'll save you time. You know, I like to say processing time 1 to 5 business days. It's just business days saves your ass, okay? Put in your website. I just use the very, this is just a template. Thank you again for your purchase. And I would put, here we go. I'm just, so if this was me, this is, I got someone, if I'm honest, professionally doing this. So I'm not going to lie. But basically, I would just put, maybe put space. Yeah, that's fine. I don't know. But you can see how, I don't know what was with the spacing there anyway. And you can change all of this, but basically this is what you do. You put your logo there, take out this. I don't know why Klaviyo does this. It's really annoying. Just bin that block. Did I bin that? Yeah, there we go. Weird. And you can see now, you know, you got your website. While we get your order ready, your order number is, and you can maybe even put that after that. It's entirely up to you. I can provide this template. You change it how you want. Processing time, 1 to 5 business days. Shipping, packing, shipping, packaging. For logistic reasons, some items may, if because you're drop shipping. Another downside with drop shipping is that you will have people that'll buy multiple different items from different suppliers, so they might have different time frames as well. So means they may not be in one package. We'll get emails about that. This sort of helps counter it. You put in the time frame. So these are my average time frames. And I'm sorry, I'm going to delete that. Average time frames. And these are the ones I use. US, UK, Australia, Canada, Western Europe, rest of the world. Gives them an idea. And then you can hyperlink to your FAQ page. Just a simple hyperlink to your FAQ page. That's it. And there you go. So now you've told them. And I put it above that because it's right in their face. Thank you for your order. Here's your packaging, blah, blah, blah. Here's your order. Here's your further info. And all you do is you go save and return to templates. It'll update. You can see how it's just updated. And all you do is you go export, copy the code, go into here, paste, control A. I use Windows. So anyway, select all the text there. Override it, click save. You can, the Klaviyo logo will be removed once you have it on paid, but it really doesn't matter anyway. People won't care. It's just, but you can see how straight away now I've got, see how that looks nicer. You can change all of this as well if you want to be absolutely ridiculous about it. It's entirely up to you, but you can see how just this looks nicer. It tells them the info because I don't have the shipping information on product page. For me, I think it hurts conversions. And so I tell them after they purchased and I handle any complaints after that. Most people honestly don't care. Most people honestly won't care. And you can even change the subject line if you really want it, of course, right? But I just leave it order name confirmed. And that's it. So I've now done an order confirmation. And as I said, I have the Klaviyo thing, but again, I like to have these because it's trust. If someone clicks it, it will take them to Klaviyo's website. They see that as a sign of trust, okay? When you're using all these apps, I look at it that, well, it might be my brand, but everyone knows that someone's going to use an email marketing software and they look at it, it's like, well, these guys are legit, okay? There's subtle little things, may or may not make a difference, but I like to think it does. So that's that one, and that's it. That's all you need to do. And then you do pretty much the same for the shipping confirmation. So you go back into here, Where's the Shopify shipping confirmation? Shopify shipping confirmation. And we've got great news, blah, 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 blah. Again, just delete this top block. Change it how you want. It's pretty much drop and drag. Plug and play. It's pretty cool. They'll get the tracking number. That'll dynamically update, which is cool. Again, you just want to put, we've got good news, blah, blah, blah. The items you have been shipped. So again, I copy this and I will change it a bit. So has been shipped. I would just take out that and just do some formatting, okay? Basically, like, it's not perfect, but it doesn't need to be. Just do some formatting. As I said, I outsource this because, well, I did a lot of it anyway. But anyway, so processing and tracking times, they see that. They see the shipping, and then they see the shipping times. Once order is processed, okay? So it's very specific, and you use business days, it technically gives you more time. Okay, so 7 to 15 business days. 15 business days is 3 weeks. And then I technically have a week for processing. So 4 weeks, okay, for United States. Obviously, overall, it's usually for me about 2 weeks. Okay, so they're very happy. 2 weeks, they get their package. And if you outsource your customer service, which you should be doing, and you stay on top of it with your suppliers, then you won't really have many problems. And you can see how you can change all of this. As I said, you can get a professional, like, to absolutely hammer the brand, stuff like that, if you really want it. It's entirely up to you. But you can see how easy this is, that it's done most of the work, and I just copy that. And does this sound like now they're going to get their purchase confirmation? So, okay, they know there. And then a couple of days later, in theory, they should get their next email. It pretty much has the same thing. You're reaffirming it for them. You're showing them your FAQ page. You're showing them your email. They can respond to that. You have your customer service team in place. Most people will be pretty happy with that because they know that there's an actual person behind these emails as well. Okay, so that's pretty much it. And again, save this, and then you just copy the code out, because you have to do it this way. Unfortunately, there's just no way else, but really easy. And again, just copy, paste, save, and done. And that's it. That's it. So those are the base ones that you need to do to work on to do that. Now, after that as well, then I'm testing this at this stage, so I will update you about it. So with the Klaviyo and AfterShip, AfterShip is fantastic. It tracks your order wherever it is around the world. It's tracking software. 10 cents an order. Absolutely worth every penny. Highly recommend it. It's free for 100 orders a month. Gives you a tracking page, gives you more authority. So just put that on your website. I have a video, previous video on that. I can't remember the name of it, but good luck. Anyway, but basically use that. And so now they've received that, they know the time frames, and then AfterShip will kick in and tell them where their order's at. And you, as I said, you can even go into AfterShip and put in the templates, the shipping times. So you just put in the shipping time frames expected. Just copy paste, because they're just templates. And you just send that to them. And so they know the whole way through, you're just slamming them with freaking emails. So about that. So I'm actually looking at also with the integration, using those flows or those triggers with Klaviyo to then send another email that's a more professionally branded email that will be a sort of follow-up on that, basically. And that's how you do it. That's how you so easily, within 10 minutes, I don't know how long this video has been running, 10 minutes, minimize a heap of emails and keep your customers happy, okay? That's all there is to it. There's not much to it at all. That's why I like Klaviyo. As far as I'm aware, it's the only one that does that, because you can obviously make them yourself. You can just create a template, do it yourself, but I'm a lazy shit. So I like to do things the easy way, and this does the job. I'm sure most of you would agree that that looks better than the default one, and you can change it anytime. And whenever you change it, just copy the code, paste it back in, you're done. And you can change it at your discretion. That's it, guys. That's all there is to it. And as I said, once you integrate Klaviyo, Once you integrate AfterShip, then you can do even more. I will update you on that in the future, okay? So that's it from today's video. I'm trying to make videos that I see that you all sort of need at the time. Videos that are still in the making are Instagram influencers, PPE versus WC myth busted. Yeah, I sound cool saying that. And a heap of others that I can't remember the life of me. I have a little list. But basically, that's it from today's video. Please drop a comment below. Especially if you do want the template, drop a comment below. I'll then upload that. If I get 50 likes, I'll upload that template for you. I really want to get more likes. I like likes. Don't forget to hit subscribe and the notification bell so then you get updates daily. I'm doing a lot of work in the YouTube space now, really trying to improve that for you all and make it a bit more of a consistent thing. The group is growing. It's still growing at a nice rate. It was booming. It slowed down a bit, which is good. Sort of makes it so that we all can learn together still. I don't want to overwhelm myself as well as everyone else. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Thanks for your time, everyone. I'll talk to you all tomorrow.